How to measure a timber pile using the Laser Geo with the 3D pile firmware application. First, the length of the timber pile is measured. Two different methods can be used. It is also possible to register the geographical coordinates of the pile. If it consists of, for example, different assortments or tree species, the pile can be divided into several sections. Heights are measured at regular intervals along the entire pile. The measurement of the pile is finished by entering a wood volume factor in percent and the width. The width is the average length of the logs in the pile. The volume of the pile is calculated per section and as a total and displayed in the Laser Geo. Now the two different methods that can be used to measure the length of the pile will be shown. The methods are 3D vector and 1PL. Start the device and select round wood. Then select new. Enter the ID specifications for the pile. When the ID is saved, the GPS will start automatically, if it is enabled. The GPS will continue to log and average the position until you choose to save. Continue registering other attributes: date, unit, site, assortment and width. Width is the average length of the logs. After the pile is created, select new section, go through the settings for the section. Enter the assortment and length. If the length is unknown and must be measured with the instrument, set the value to 0. 3D vector. How to measure the length of the timber pile using the 3D vector method. After the length value is set to 000.0, select 3D vector. Position yourself so that you can see the start and end point of the pile. Aim with the aim point sight on the starting point of the pile. Do a short press to fire the laser. Continue aiming until the sight goes out and a short signal is heard. The value will then show in the heads-up display. Save the value and measure the end point of the pile in the same way, then also save the end point value. Once the value is saved, the length of the pile is calculated and will show in the heads-up display. 1PL length. How to measure the length of the timber pile using the 1PL length method. With this method, it is recommended that you use something to aim and shoot at, for example a cone. This is to make it clear where to measure. After the length value is set to 0, select 1PL length. Position yourself so that you can see the end point of the pile. Stand at the starting point of the pile. It is marked with a cone in this case. Aim with the aim point sight on the end point of the pile. The cone in this case. Do a short press to fire the laser. Continue aiming until the sight goes out and a short signal is heard. Save the endpoint value. Once the value is saved, the length of the pile will show in the heads-up display. Now the two different methods that can be used to measure the heights of the pile will be shown. The methods are 2P and 1PL. 2P. How to measure the heights using 2P, two-point measuring. You measure the top and vertically below at the bottom of the pile. This is the safest method if the bottom of the pile is not completely horizontal. For example, on a slope, or if the pile is laying on logs. After the length has been measured and saved for the pile, select method, height 2P. Stand at the first position to be measured on the pile. First point, aim on the first measuring point at top of the pile, do a short press to fire the laser. And continue aiming until the sight goes out and a short signal is heard. The value will then show in the heads-up display. Second point, measure vertically below the first point at the bottom of the pile. Press the button and keep it pressed until the sight goes out and a short signal is heard. Save the value and move to the next position on the pile and measure a new height in the same way, top then bottom, until the entire pile is measured. Measure heights at regular intervals along the entire pile. 1PL. How to measure the heights using 1PL, one-point laser measuring. With this method, you only measure the top of the pile. This method requires that the bottom of the pile is completely horizontal and flat to the ground and that it is on the same ground level as yourself. If not, use method 2P. After the length has been measured and saved for the pile, select method, height 1PL. Aim with the aim point sight on the top of the pile. Do a short press to fire the laser. Continue aiming until the sight goes out and a short signal is heard. The value will then show in the heads-up display. Save the value and move to the next point and measure a new height in the same way until the entire pile is measured. Measure heights at regular intervals along the entire pile. When the length and heights have been measured on the pile, the entire measurement is finished by specifying the width and the wood volume factor on the pile. Enter the wood volume factor in percent and the width, the average log length. The number of heights, average height and volume for the section are then presented in the display.